You will be shocked when you learn about the amazing innovation introduced by Japanese engineers from Toyota. These guys have managed to create a truly astonishing engine that runs on ordinary water. Today I will explain how it works, what its performance is like, the challenges the manufacturer faced, and where it can be used. At the end of the video, I'll also explain why, even though they have working prototypes, we won't see this engine on the market anytime soon. Enjoy watching. First in the world. Let me introduce you to the Toyota AquaDrive, the first engine in the world to run on water. When I first heard about this, I couldn't believe my ears. How could water, the very substance we drink every day, become fuel for a car? It sounds like science fiction, but it's the reality created by a team of brilliant engineers and scientists at the renowned Toyota company. And their AquaDrive invention is not just a new engine, it's a symbol of change and hope for a better future. At least, that's what people are saying online. But is that really the case? That's what I want to figure out today. But first, let's understand how this engine works. AquaDrive uses advanced hydrolysis technology to convert water into clean energy. What struck me the most is how elegant and efficient this process is. Water enters the system, where a special catalyst splits it into hydrogen and oxygen. The hydrogen is then used as fuel to power the engine, and the only emission is water vapor. Just imagine, no carbon dioxide, no harmful substances, only clean energy and fresh air. Performance. You're probably wondering, what about the performance? I was skeptical myself until I learned about the first tests of a car using this engine. It accelerates from 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 7 seconds. The AquaDrive runs quietly, yet you can still feel the power and smoothness typical of Toyota's best models. The handling is intuitive, and the throttle response is instantaneous. It's truly impressive how well the balance between eco-friendliness and dynamic performance is maintained. Those lucky enough to drive this car felt confident on the road, knowing they didn't have to sacrifice speed or comfort. But the most important factor is its impact on the environment. Every kilometer driven with AquaDrive makes a significant contribution to preserving our planet. The absence of harmful emissions means cleaner air for us to breathe, and using water as fuel reduces reliance on fossil fuels. And this isn't like modern electric cars, which require massive amounts of resources to produce, often poisoning the planet in the process. Moreover, producing electricity for such vehicles consumes a huge amount of coal, with emissions exceeding all acceptable limits. By the way, I've already made a video on that topic. Comparison with existing technologies. The most important benefit people have gained from this invention is that there are no emissions into the atmosphere. I'd like to dwell on this a bit more. Traditional internal combustion engines use gasoline or diesel fuel, burning it to generate energy. This process is inefficient and results in the emission of carbon dioxide and other harmful substances, which contribute to environmental pollution and climate change. Though I'm sure you already know this, electric vehicles run on electricity stored in batteries. They don't produce emissions while driving, making them more eco-friendly, but that's only at first glance. What other types of engines are there? For example, hybrids. They combine an internal combustion engine with an electric motor, which helps reduce fuel consumption and emissions compared to traditional engines. However, hybrid cars still depend on fossil fuels and have a complex design, which can increase maintenance costs. There are also hydrogen engines. Essentially, they work similarly to this incredible innovation, except they use hydrogen, not water. Hydrogen is much harder to obtain, more dangerous to store, and less convenient to use. So this option isn't the best either. And what about AquaDrive? It's probably the most ideal option at the moment. All we need is water. Emissions are almost non-existent, which in my opinion is a significant plus. What problems might arise? But do you know what bothers me the most? The fact that this innovation might face some serious problems. Companies developing new engines to replace traditional internal combustion engines often face a range of issues that slow down their development and mass market adoption. These problems can be roughly divided into technological, economic, infrastructural, and social categories. I'd like to go through them one by one. One of the main challenges is achieving the necessary level of energy efficiency comparable to modern internal combustion engines. New technologies, such as electric engines, hydrogen engines, or hybrid solutions, require serious innovations in energy storage and transmission. For example, electric vehicles rely on batteries that are either too expensive or have low capacity, limiting their range on a single charge. Fortunately, AquaDrive solves many of these issues, as its performance is quite remarkable. However, there's still one thing that worries me. What about reliability? Many innovations in the development of new engines encounter another obstacle. Maintaining new power systems is expensive, difficult, and often impossible. But Toyota assures us that this won't be a problem either. Their AquaDrive Aqua Drive will be extremely reliable, with parts that are very affordable, and perhaps the biggest challenge is money. Developing innovative engines requires huge investments in research and development. Many companies haven't been able to secure enough funding to bring their products to mass production. Luckily, this project is in the hands of a large company, so they're sure to see it through. When can we expect it on the market? Okay, let's assume all the previous problems have been solved. The company has introduced its latest development in a few prototypes. What's next? The hardest part? Setting up technological processes, building factories, launching production, and doing all this in the shortest time with the least investment. Plus, this production must be efficient and extremely reliable, with a minimal defect rate. Otherwise, your innovative development is bound to face criticism in the market. Nobody wants to buy a new car that falls apart on the road due to defects just a few days after purchase. Well, okay, I won't try to scare you. Let's just talk about what's most important. What about the infrastructure in different countries? Many nations still don't even have charging stations for electric cars. This is happening in Europe and the West, although you'd think it's a trend right now since everyone is using or making these cars. So what's going to happen with the new engine that runs on water? It's going to face a tough time. And no, don't think any water will do. If you could just take water from the nearest river or lake, there'd be no questions. But that's definitely impossible. Why am I so sure? It's all because no complex technical device, with so many small parts, can function properly if it's constantly exposed to dirt or any kind of living organisms. These vehicles will require specialized refueling stations with clean water, maybe even distilled water. Now, take a look around your city. How many water filters do you see for drinking water? Personally, in my city, there aren't any at all. So think about how long it will take before we have specialized refueling stations for cars, where they will need to pump in huge amounts of purified water. Is it even convenient? Let's go back to the feedback from the lucky ones who've gotten to try this miracle. One of the most noticeable advantages is the silence of the Aqua Drive. Unlike traditional internal combustion engines, this engine runs almost silently. When the car is idling or moving at low speeds, you can hardly hear it. A light hum only appears under heavy load, but even then, it's much quieter compared to regular cars. This is especially nice in traffic jams or urban environments where noise levels are already quite high. Many compare this sound to electric cars, as the noise is nearly identical. And what about fuel consumption? As for water consumption, Aqua Drive does require some water for cooling. However, the amount of water needed to keep it running is relatively small. Depending on the operating conditions, such as the ambient temperature or intensity of use, you only need to refill the system with water about once a month, which is convenient and doesn't require constant attention. The refueling process itself is quite simple and quick, so it doesn't cause any real difficulties in daily life. By the way, car manufacturers will also be happy because the weight of this engine is comparable to classic internal combustion engines. It may be slightly heavier, but it's definitely lighter than the batteries used in electric cars. If not cars, then... By the way, I've been thinking, why does everyone only talk about this development in the context of cars? This kind of engine could be useful in so many other areas. For example, Aqua Drive would be perfect for small watercraft like boats, yachts, or fishing vessels. In maritime transport, efficiency, quiet operation, and eco-friendliness are key, especially in areas with noise and emission restrictions, such as nature reserves or tourist spots. And on a boat, it would be easy to install a filtration system and constantly maintain a fuel supply on board. If we can scale this technology up to large sizes and high power levels, even massive cargo ships could start running on ordinary water. What are the advantages of this? For us as end consumers, the prices of everyday goods could drop significantly. Literally, a new phone or even potatoes in the store could become cheaper because manufacturers wouldn't have to spend as much on transportation. Additionally, various types of industrial machinery, such as excavators, loaders, or cranes, could use Aqua Drive to increase eco-friendliness and reduce noise levels. Surely, like me, you're annoyed by all the noise from construction sites. Well, these industrial machines could help solve that problem. No more noisy excavators clearing snow outside your window in winter, or garbage trucks making a racket while picking up bins near your house. Public transport and energy. I'd also like to point out that very convenient, comfortable, and quiet electric buses are starting to appear around the world. These are just regular buses that run on electricity. Now, imagine not having to refuel them for several hours at specialized stations, and they'd be even safer and more maneuverable. It's a miracle, and thanks to this latest development, it's becoming a reality. In my opinion, water-powered engines like these will be in demand for creating public transport, and perhaps most importantly, electricity production. You all know there are different ways to generate electricity, burning fossil fuels using peaceful nuclear power or harnessing nature's energy. The cleanest and most interesting method is probably using nature. This includes hydroelectric power plants, solar stations, and wind turbines. But only hydro plants are highly productive. However, they are incredibly expensive to build. Well, Toyota's development will allow for the creation of super cool, environmentally friendly power stations. They will be very quiet, efficient, and easy to use near bodies of water. You just set up a purification plant and then use that water to generate energy. It's simply genius. And of course, let's not forget about small diesel generators. They are incredibly useful because you can use them anywhere, on a construction site, while camping, or for temporary housing. But they come with many downsides. They're extremely loud, they stink, and they emit harmful gases. In short, they're awful. Now imagine not having to deal with all those problems anymore. Isn't that a miracle? When can we expect mass production? But the most important question, unfortunately, remains unanswered. When can we expect mass production and sale of these wonderful engines? Well, the technology has already been created. It just needs to be optimized. This means planning the technological lines in the factories, hiring employees, and setting up global supply chains. For a large company like Toyota, this will take a couple of years, maybe three. However, something tells me that it will actually take much longer. Oil companies definitely won't want to give up their black gold. And let's not forget that many will try to throw a wrench in the works for the geniuses from Japan. The global and political situation isn't the best either. So, I'm afraid this development might take a back seat, and we as end consumers will only see more crossovers and other not-so-quality cars. Though, in my opinion, Toyota only makes cool and reliable vehicles. But of course, I hope all my thoughts turn out to be wrong, and we can buy a car that runs on water as soon as tomorrow. In this video, we discussed the latest amazing development by Japanese engineers. What do you think of this engine? Share in the comments how soon you think we'll be able to buy a car that runs on water. I'd like to once again emphasize that the geniuses and professionals at Toyota are truly remarkable. And do you know where else professionals are needed? In our team. Friends, you have the opportunity to join us. If you have skills in video editing, can voice over videos in Russian, English, and other languages, or write interesting scripts, we would be happy to work with you. Message us on our Telegram bot. The link is in the description. Thank you for your attention.